Hello and welcome back to Charwell. So we just stopped pulling tree farm at the moment, having dropped the sulky drill and fertilizer spreader up here. Now heading back down to the house with the fin. We've had the dealership out having a look at the sugar beet drill. It's just a small electrical fault I've been fixing on that, because we've got a beet drilling job come in. So while I'm fixing that, I've just been moving some machinery about. So we've still got a little bit more to bring up here yet. Top down carrier, two Gardastat drills, trailer sprayer come up here, and of course the three tractors. And we can retrieve all the machinery from our other farm. We may get some of that brought over by lorry at the moment. Handy that road being closed, I haven't got more about stuff coming from the left there. It shouldn't take us too long to move the rest of the machinery. Just a case of running it around now. We have got a builder coming and a company coming to install our liquid fertiliser tanks up the farm as well. Rather than buying it in the containers, we'll get bulk delivery of it. Well, no dealer's van in the yard still, so I'm guessing they've got our drill sorted. Get this backed up to the trailer ready. Hooked on. So that's all ready to go up there very shortly. But for now, we'll go and get this beet drilling job done. So let's get this tractor started. Get the drill folded up. And head off to the field. Seems the previous contractor's retired who used to drill beet in this area, so we may get a bit of work. Seed has been delivered to Pine Tree Farm, so if we haven't got enough on board to do this field, we will have to go and get some. Carry it in the cab with me. So we're going next door to the field we ploughed power harrowed in the past couple of videos. Too far across to Pine Tree Farm from here either, which is handy if we do run out of seed. Don't it's too big a field here. Get the headlands done first. So let's get this turned on and get going. So off we go. So might be an avenue we have to explore if the beat contractor is retired in this area. Always looking for new revenue streams. Big field, just a bit of an odd shape. So I've still got the contract's potato plant that they're working on. So I'll say we will drill it with this side of the field, looking at this. GPS coming down this way. For those wondering why we're leaving corners, it's to help with the harvesting. Space for the harvester. I say us, whoever harvests them. Never know by that time it might be us. Drilled on the headland, normally 36. GPS going down the side, so it's all set up now. It's quite a good drill this one, so we can go a decent speed with it, not the usual walking speed. Drill sugar beet up. That's why we chose the coon drill. And the Nevada stat would do it as well that we bought. But the problem with that is we would have to change all the units around and all the discs around in it to do it. So it wouldn't be set up for maize if we had to do any more of that or any other crops that the locals want us to drill for them. So I'd rather have one drill at wide spacings than this one at the narrower spacings. job. The drill's got some decent unit suspension on it because I ain't done a very good job pulling this field down level. To move a couple more bits of machinery after we've drilled this field. Get out of the other yard. It's quite a common practice to drill headless first with sugar beet. Don't waste so much seed that way. The seed is expensive. So let's just get the bottom headland done and then we can go up and down on the field. I'm running the drill back to Pine Tree Farm over there. Drop that off in the barn. And we'll probably run back to the house and got the sprayer then for this tractor. So we better just go and check these seeds before we go any further. Hoppers. Okay, so we've still got enough seed at the moment. We should be okay there. This drill's a bit heavy on this tractor still. Can get. Let's get the drawing up now and you can see what's going on from outside. Let's see how well the drill is flowing from outside. See just how loyal the front of the tractor looks as well, which probably isn't the best. It's not the best of seed beds on this field, but at least it's going in. Because we can do that quite nicely. Just spin it around on the headlands. get everything moved into our new yard now. Tommy might see if we're getting a house built this way, but we'll have to see on that one. Person's just asked us to drill this for now. So if the sugar beet doesn't do well this year, it'll be as last year growing it. So it comes to the decision that the abnormal weather, how wet it was, winter has been the problem with this existing crop, which we had to remove. So that would be the low seed warning. So I will go and fill this up with seed and finish the field. And see you back at Pine Tree Farm once I've done that. We'll get on with the next little job. So I'll see you in a few moments. Okay, so field is now finished and we're on our way back to Pine Tree Farm. Through the village now. Building work has finally been finished up here by the looks of it. The road is no longer blocked by a skip. I've removed the temporary traffic calming as well. So that's going to help us out a great deal now. This road work's been going on a long while up here with that skip on the road. Nice clear passage through the village now. It's not so bad having to come through that way. So we made a few changes up here. We've actually pulled the hedge out along the roadside just to give us better visibility in out of the yard. In the shed. We'll be setting it down and folded so it's more stable. It will stand folded as we know, but just for pure safety reasons we'll have it down. Also means I can get out to work on it if necessary. So let's just get this disconnected. Back and get another machine to bring up here. Got another 3 days to get out of the yard yet. It's just the big stuff to bring. So it won't take us so long now. trip back. Distance back to our yard, really, but there's no quicker way of getting there. The spray we grab on this tractor is a set with rotor wheels. Makes more sense to us. We can probably leave both these vehicles up Pine Tree Farm then. Just be able to get in there to the sprayer, I think. Not allowed to take the vent first. Right, let's get this all connected. Okay. As I said, this, although we've only just bought this sprayer, its future is already hanging in the balance. There we go, getting more work. Wondering whether we need a bigger sprayer. Field is all trail mined at 24 metres, which isn't going to help. Let's make that pull a bit harder. Up here now, and that'll do us for today. Just be nice to get everything back to one place, between three different yards. Two main ones and our old one over the other way. Nice to get all the other machinery back from there. cattle groups about here. This must have had a lot of livestock in the area originally. Shed over here. Gotta have a bit of a site survey done for the fertilizer tanks in here. Good thing is the whole yard is concrete, is it? So it's not gonna be a big issue to us where we put them. For now, that is where I'm going to be leaving this video for today. So I will say thank you for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.